several members of the CIAA present to continue this conversation. I think the letter that we received previously speaking for itself, the our association is looking at expanding hours not only for official night during the week, but also possibly weekends, particularly in the summer when there's a lot of tourist traffic in the city now, to enable visitors and residents to view the artwork when they're out without just strolling around. In addition, they're looking for some exterior signage outside of town hall to provide notice that there is an art exhibit available to be viewed in town hall. So with that, I will ask let's see, the outgoing, the incoming president,
outgoing,
which he's going.
Where are you going?
Outgoing.
Recall president.
Recall back to duty.
My name is Don Miller, I'm the former president of the CIAA. We did in fact have three requests in that letter. Some possible extension of hours, a plaque, and possible purchase of a piece of art. None of these items are items that would cost the town anything. With the possible exception of the lighting. As far as the extended hours go, we would demand those hours if it was possible. I know that maybe some certain rules, I'm not sure what would be required if we could put a person here, possibly something on Thursday evening or possibly a Saturday afternoon, and this would only be during the summer months of July and August. So from our point of view, that would not involve expenditures of the town. We would like to place a small 8.5 by 11 or something similar size plaque, just noting that the CIAA is the group of people that provide art through the year in the town hall. The words would be subject to your approval. We don't have a presentation at this time as far as what those words would be. Suggestion and discussion. Regarding the possible purchase of a piece of artwork, one of our members suggested that to add to the town's permanent collection of art, that we would ask a sponsor, a commercial establishment here in town, to purchase a piece of art from a Connecticut Island Art Association member. And that piece of art could be presented to the town council, et cetera, to be held here, paid for by that sponsor.
You know, I don't have that letter in the packet.
So I don't either.
We didn't get a copy of the letter with all the information that they were requesting.
We had a last
I didn't bring it back.
Peter, I hate to do this, but this talks about extended hours. We don't get into the flap or, I know, we talked, you had this in your letter last time.
That's okay, I'm referring to it, yes.
Right, but we don't have it on the agenda as such. Is that what you mean?
No, that doesn't, but the whole issue is before you about the extended hours.
The extended hours.
You can certainly talk about the flap, but that's not a problem.
And then purchasing as well.
It's all related.
Purchasing the art is really doesn't require a town council action. Other than say you will, if a commercial entity on the island does buy one of the pieces from CIA, that you will consider, that you will accept it as a gift to the town.
There's no action for us.
Okay, get out. Get out.
Is that what was phrased in your last letter?
Well, there's only been one letter.
I know, the previous letter.
I don't have a witness, so I can't.
Well, the letter actually states that the CIA proposes that once you earn a piece of art from a CIA member, be purchased by the town
to
be part of an ongoing collection.
So the same person by the town?
Yeah, that's what I remember.
That's an error.
Right. Well, the way you explained it tonight, I talked to Helen for us to do this.
So
extended hours or the purpose of the hour?
Let's do the hours.
Okay.
Hours.
What exact hours were you talking about? It says one night and one weekend during the summer season to facilitate the viewing and sale of art staffed by a CIA member. We're responsible for the premises.
So what are you asking for? What would you like?
What would you like? Ideally, it would be perhaps Thursday evening, and we would say, oh, here until 7:30 o'clock. And Saturday afternoon, perhaps a walk at 4, 11 to 3, subject to discussion and obviously their decisions.
Do we have a normal process where people request the use of town facilities and permits, or this would be, and actually they're looking to sell art at the same time? I'm a little uncomfortable about turning the town hall into a retail establishment. And that, you know, probably need a permit anyways and a tax certificate to do so. There's a lot more involved in this saying that you can open it up for a certain amount of hours. And I believe that we would require some town staff or insurance coverage, correct?
You should. I mean, you don't have a policy on this. And so if you're doing this, you need to think through all these questions because they are important matters to consider.
Yeah, I'm worried about, and I know that's very different from worried about the application for the hot dog guy. Yes. We, you know, as we open this up, what happens?
Yes. Not probably. Yes, they need to think
about that. It's not waiting here to build, but I was saying, as we open this up for the sale of art, when do we stop it? And if
as a matter of point of reference, we have sold, we do sell art from this establishment. We have, in the 2.5 years or so that we have pump art, and we have been totally upfront about that. The CIA makes a small amount of money, and the parts make a small amount of money as well. So it's not something that, part of it is not new.
Right.
From our
right.
Days.
Some of them, not this one, but some of the other signs are for sale.
Yeah, I mean, everything is for sale. In fact, when some of the friends are, if they bring only one piece of art, that has to be for sale. If they bring two, at least one of those pieces that are hung has to be for sale. And it's part of the encouragement that we try to impart to any of our members. We would like them to have the opportunity to sell something. Because it encourages them to participate.
Apparently, I didn't know that you were running a house on sale in the past. I thought it was an art show where you were just displaying the underwritten message of course is everything's for sale, but I hadn't really understood that it was a requirement to display the art to be for sale.
It is.
I didn't know that.
It's the policy that we started from the beginning because we don't want this to take ourselves out of that possibility. We are a nonprofit organization, but we still need to have a certain number of funds that come in so we exist.
Are these sales happening on the town property or are they private sales?
They are not necessarily happening here. I couldn't say they have never happened.
They're not happening through the town. Well, okay. Yeah. And we're not acting as naked or anything else. We're just allowing space for art to be displayed. Two people to meet and possibly engage in a transaction here or something.
I'd say the sale is incidental to
the display.
Yeah, it's basically, we are providing a space for an art gallery for the sale of the art. It's not unusual for various establishments, restaurants, etc., to show art. And I know I've purchased a couple of birthday presents for my wife while we were having dinner at a restaurant because we liked the picture, and so we bought it. So I know that happens.
Yeah.
And we did have quite a bit of discussion when we authorized the CIA to display art here.